My name is Andrew Allee, and I'm a PhD candidate at the Thayer School, and I'm also a research fellow with RMI's Africa Energy Program. What initially, you know, attracted me to the Thayer School was the fact that there were no departmental boundaries. That it seemed very flexible, and sort of that interdisciplinary aspect of it stood out from other graduate programs. Foremost in my mind coming into the Thayer School was sort of a humanitarian motivation to think about energy as a tool to solve problems that people are facing. And the Thayer School has actually added a layer to that. Mainly Mary Albert's climate change course impressed upon me the reality that the mission to stabilize the climate is also a humanitarian mission, because the people who are least poised to adapt to a changing climate are precisely the poorest people who are, you know, struggling to meet the sustainable development goals that we have today. I guess in that sense, the Thayer School sort of broadened my idea of how my work fits into that whole equation, and how pursuit of climate change mitigation is also, it's a human problem at its core. From a research point of view, I think the contribution is to figure out what's preventing us from getting where we are to where we want to be. And sometimes those things are knowledge gaps. And so I look at knowledge gaps in two technologies. One is bioenergy, and the second is distributed energy resources, or things like mini grids, solar home systems that give people access to electricity. When you dig down into each of those technologies, you sort of find little unsolved problems that, with some engineering training and some applied thinking on solving the problem, you can sort of fill in a gap and help move things forward. And that's sort of also what enabled me to come onto RMI's Africa Energy Program. I had been working on things with Lee on the biofuel side regarding land use, studying drivers of food security, and sort of things that bioenergy touches. And I also had an interest in getting down to the electrification side of things, like energy access. How do you bring that to people's homes and businesses? And the RMI team was working in Nigeria and Ethiopia at the time on scaling mini grids as a means of providing electricity access in rural places in sub-Saharan Africa. And I was able to join their team because I had this external support, and start building out research projects alongside my work that I was doing with the RMI team. After I graduate, I'm going to be joining the RMI Africa Energy Program full-time.